Hello dear students, today's lecture is for 6th semester B.sc. Botany on the topic gene-gene interaction in the prescribed syllabus of paper genetics and plant breeding. As we have discussed, the gene-gene interactions are of two types, intragenic and intergenic, in which we have discussed, we already had discussed 9:7 ratio of complementary genes. Today we will discuss the duplicate effect or duplicate factor 15:1 or duplicate dominant effect 15:1. In this type of interaction, two or more genes either individually or in combination produce the same phenotypic effect. Means there are two genes which duplicately they act with each other and produce the same phenotypic effect. For an example, if a rice variety having awned grains, as you can see these awns on the seeds, these awned grains which is governed by a dominant gene set A1 and A2. You can also write it as A and B, both capital. Here I have taken A1 and A2 genes, which are two separate genes, but both are responsible for awned character of the grain. Is crossed with awnless grain, as you can observe here, the awnless grains. This awnless character is governed by two genes which are both recessive, A1, small A1 and small A2. When they are crossed, they produced awned grain in F1 generation, as due to the law of dominance states that the dominant gene will show its expression. Now in F2 generation, when the F1 was selved, we produced 15 awned and 1 awnless, which we have to solve out. So the solution is, it is due to the duplicate effect or duplicate factor effect. Here the awned character is governed by the two genes, both are dominant, A1 and A2, and awnless character by A1 small and A2 small. The parents are A1 A1, A2 A2, capital all, and awnless are small A1 with small A2, small A2. Now the gametes, fertilization, produced F1 generation, all awned because of law of dominance. This is dominant and this is dominant, which upon selfing, as we have to self here, and we will make the gametes A1 A2 like this and cross these gametes with each other, crossing this with here, crossing this with again this, crossing the third one with first one, third, fourth one with first one. So the 16 individuals are produced, in which we can observe that A1 A1, when present, both are present, and A2 A2 both are present, they will produce awned variety. Here also awned, here also awned, but individually where only A1 is present, capital A1 is present, is also producing A1 variety, and the A2 where individually present is also producing awned variety. So we can see that both A1 and A2 capitals are able to produce the duplicate effect of producing awned variety. In this case, where all are recessive, A1, A1 as well as A2, A2, both the genes are in recessive form, so this will be awnless because it has neither capital A1 nor capital A2. Both of the genes are absent. Now there is another example. In Capsula, which is called Shepherd's Purse, one plant has triangular capsule and other has a top-shaped capsule. As you can observe here, this has a triangular capsule and this has a top-shaped capsule. Triangular capsule is a dominant feature, while top-shaped capsule is a recessive feature. So both when mated, they produce triangular capsule plant, which upon selfing produced 15:1 ratio. This is due to the duplicate effect, 15:1. Where we will denote triangular by both dominant genes T1, T1, T2, T2, and small T1, T1, T2, T2 will represent the recessive character, which is top shaped. All the individuals where either T1 or T2 is present singly or in doubles, if any dominant is present, they will show triangular capsule. The last one, which is having all four recessive, will produce the top shaped capsule. Hence, we can observe 15 triangular and 1 top shaped individuals. Thanks.